Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at hidden pages you may not know about at Apple.com. So I want to talk about pages at the Apple.com website that you may not know about that are either useful, interesting, or entertaining. And the best place to start is support.apple.com/manuals. And here you'll find user manuals for the current Apple products and a lot of past ones as well. So if you thought, well, I didn't get a user manual with my iPhone or iPad or Mac, well, there is one. It's available as a PDF. Now, an interesting place to go is support.apple.com/specs. And here you'll find specifications for current and past Apple products. Apple has a special page at /batteries. That talks just about the batteries and the products. Of course, most Apple products use batteries nowadays. In addition to this information page, you can also click on a link here, how to get the most out of your battery, which includes lots of advice from Apple for different products about how to extend and best use the battery in your device. Now, a page that's really not so much a secret, but people don't utilize it enough, is apple.com/support. So if you go here, of course, you have all your support options for different devices. And this is the main place where you start when you have trouble and you want to make a Genius Bar appointment or get help on the phone. Now, here's where you also can go into the discussion area to get help in the forums. And you can also schedule things like one-on-one training and things like that at Apple stores. But there's another place you can go if you're looking for some general help, and that's apple.com/user groups. And this is the gateway to finding a local user group where you can meet other Mac and iOS device users. You can click on Find a Group, which actually takes you to a special website supported by Apple, and you could find user groups in your area. And there are thousands of these across the world. So even if you think, well, I'm not in a big enough city to support one, there probably is an Apple user group near you, and they probably meet regularly. Now, suppose that you want to give Apple some feedback for a suggestion for something you think should be in an app or in one of their products. There's a place for that as well. There's apple.com/feedback. And here you can choose your product and fill out a form to send to Apple. Another hidden spot a lot of people don't know about in the Apple website is if you go to the subsite appleid.apple.com. And this is where you can get help with your Apple ID, also known as your iTunes account, your Apple account. You can manage it here. You can create a new account. You can reset your password. Most big websites that have lots of different services also have a status page where you can see if a service is up or down. And Apple's no exception. You go to support/system status and you get this screen here that shows you all of the different parts of the Apple online ecosystem and tells you whether they're up or down and if there's any scheduled maintenance and things like that. So if something's not working for you, this might be the first place to go to see if, well, everybody's having the problem or if it's just you. Now, if you're looking for a place to buy Apple products, of course, you might know your local Apple store. You can go to apple.com/buy, and from this location, you can find a Apple store, certainly, but you can also find another type of reseller. So speaking of buying Macs, of course, store.apple.com is the Apple store. One of the things you may not know is you can find refurbished Macs here. So you go to Shop Mac, and then from there you can find this little arrow here and you can scroll over to find different things like accessories and such, and eventually you get to certified refurbished. And Apple has a whole little store within a store with refurbished Macs that you can buy. There's also a section of the Apple store at this long URL, US Browse Reuse and Recycle with underscores there, where you can go and trade in your old iPhone, iPad, or Mac for a gift card. So of course a big part of the Apple website is iTunes.apple.com, the iTunes store, and most of the time you view this in the iTunes app, but you can see some stuff on the web. For instance, if you go to this address here, you can browse music in your web browser rather than actually going to the iTunes app, and you can view lots of information about groups and albums and things like that, and eventually you're going to end up going into the iTunes app, but you can look quite a bit here. There's even a special section if you go to apple.com/iTunes/charts. You can see all the different iTunes charts for like top songs and books and movies and apps and things like that. There's even another section. Say the group that you want isn't in iTunes. you can go to feedback.itunes.html and it takes you right to the feedback section where you can actually request that an artist or some other content be included in the iTunes store. Now if you're serious about using Macs and you know a lot about them and you think it could add to your career or your job or create a new job for you, you can go to training.apple.com and here's where you can get certification. So you can actually get official certification from Apple. Likewise, if you'd want a job with Apple, you can go to /jobs and then it redirects you to your local area. And you can look for jobs at Apple Corporate, at the retail stores, even some internships and other things. Now no look at the hidden features of the Apple site would be complete if we didn't go to trailers.apple.com. And Apple started this a long time ago, mostly to promote things in iTunes, and they keep up with it, putting high definition movie trailers for movies. It's probably the most comprehensive trailer site that I've seen. Certainly is better than a lot because it doesn't really have any ads on here. For easy access, I'll put a list of all of these links at this post at macmost.com.